Get ready to match the stars from Shenandoah, Bowser, Russ Summers, Charles Dulcerani, from Morgan Mindy, Gina Hepp, Bill Daly, and Fanny Pryor as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Rayburn.
Hi, John. Okay. What's your problem, John? Oh. Hello there.
Hello there.
Hi, guys.
You're a friendly bunch, aren't you?
I don't know. I'm not sure of that.
Are you friendly?
Yes.
Are the natives up here friendly?
Yes, we're friendly. Yes.
Why are you so preoccupied, Charles?
Preoccupied.
Oh. Why are you so quiet?
I'm not quiet. Oh. I'm just sitting waiting for the game to begin.
What a pro.
Just because I didn't ooh-ah in the pants, I don't really feel matches the vest and the coat. Maybe that's got me depressed. I don't feel it matches right.
I think it's a perfect ensemble.
Let's say a word to Robin Citron and Jim Hindle over here.
Hey, Hindle.
Let's see. To refresh my memories, Robin. Now, wait a minute. I'll remember now. It'll take me a second or two.
She's a jogger,
right. Yes. And her knees are going, and her hips are falling apart. Other than that, she's a very attractive lady, isn't she?
Yeah.
Hello there, Robin.
Hello.
What else you want to say?
That's about the most important part, isn't it?
Right. Hips and knees, right. And Jim is a senior at USC, right?
Yep.
And he's going to go in business administration.
Yep.
What end? Are you going to start a business of yourself? Or are you going to lose other people's money? Or what are you going to do?
I'm going to interview with, like, large corporations.
Okay.
Try to go into the corporation.
Now, is this game number one? Right. Robin, you are number one up at the bat.
I will pick B.
Okay, there it is.
That's Citron, like the car.
Like
that's
the
right.
Like
I hope you're related to them.
Citroën.
Citroën.
Ed said I just read a revised...
Ed said I just read
a revised version of the Bible.
Uh-oh.
Now, this one was really revised. How really was it? You are weird. Instead of Adam and Eve taking a bite of an apple... They took a bite of a blank. That's it. I just read a revised version of the Bible, and this one was really revised. Instead of Adam and Eve taking a bite of an apple, they took a bite of a blank.
A bite of each other.
A bite of each other. A bite of each other. A bite of each other.
Yeah.
Whatever could she mean, Bowser?
I'm thinking, Gene. Grease for peace.
Right.
I said snake.
They bit the snake.
I think I would have preferred each other.
Yes. They bit the snake, you said.
Had I been them.
What did she say?
A bite of each other.
A bite of each other?
Right.
Criminy Dutch. Each other.
Each other.
Quarter pounder.
Ah! Now there's an au courant,
yes.
Definitive answer.
Good answer.
Totally au courant. What do you say, Gina?
Well, I don't know. I think that's a little racy, but I gotta tell you, I like it.
One another. Two. See, the correct answer doesn't always match, Charles.
But
what
I
do
like
you
snakes.
Got?
I was close. I had took a bite of a fig leaf, so it's.
That is close. That's
no cigar,
close.
Bill.
I think that's a match.
Sing, Dennis. All right, Fanny.
Well, this is in honor of Anne Blythe. I said they took a bite of a Hostess Twinkie.
Ah. That would bring it up to date, wouldn't it?
Really?
Nobody put one.
All right, two for Robin on her first rounder. Jim, let's see how you do with yours. Ted said the weather is going to be terrible.
Uh-oh.
I can tell.
Where are they going, to California?
Hey, California, it's cold and it's damp. And boy. Ted said, the weather's going to be terrible. I can tell my neighbor is even putting aluminum siding on his blank.
Well, look at the man. What would you do? Man who's a vision.
You do wear great. You want to check it? You want to check the labels on both these articles?
We're not interested in labels. Instead we're interested
something
in outcome.
Rembrandt gave away in 1902.
All right, Jim, if you're ready to carry on, we will. Ted said the weather's going to be terrible, and I can tell. My neighbor is even putting aluminum siding on his...
bed?
Oh. Is that the first thing you thought of?
Yeah.
What's the second thing you thought of?
Car.
Car?
They're both bad.
Both losers, Jim.
Pardon me?
Uh-oh.
Come again?
Guy gives a weird answer, and this weirdo's going to match him, I'll bet.
Well...
I bet he's going to match him.
Don't speak. You know, snakes are a delicacy. Just want everyone to know that. Yeah, caw.
He didn't say caw.
That was his second choice.
I know.
Yeah, all right.
Yeah, but they booed that one even worse than they booed Ben.
I know it.
No.
Come up here and say that.
The weather was so terrible.
Sit down.
Hi, hon. The weather was so terrible, he had to put aluminum siding on his wife.
Yay! That's what I say on his wife, certainly.
Aluminum siding on his aluminum
That's
siding.
Aha! Aha!
I love it.
There's an interesting answer.
I'll get this over quick.
Oh. Gina, my neighbor's even putting aluminum siding on his...
on his pool?
On his pool.
Look, it's Gina, it's dead. Yeah. Except.
I'll defend you, Gina.
Now listen, in all defense of Gina, I must say it's the first rotten answer she's gave.
I've done real good up till this point.
Yeah. Got another wife here. Two wives. One uncle and a partridge.
Why are you off there?
Two wives do not
Three
a husband
wives.
Make.
Okay. That was what she was looking for. So there we are at the end of round one. 2-0 favor Robin. Round two coming up. First kiss message for you. Hello.
Hi.
All right. Well, we're ready to go on.
Isn't it fun
and
to be sick?
Robin, since you're ahead,
you go first.
Robin, we go first. You want A or you want B?
I want B.
Man has
okay.
gone bad.
Well, he's getting
got the flu.
I'm
going to
some of whatever you're having.
Neil said the economy is in really bad shape. I haven't seen anything drop this low since I saw blank take off her bra.
Oh, what? Oh. Oh.
Okay, Robin. Neil said the economy is in really bad shape. I haven't seen anything drop this low since I saw blank take off her bra.
Since we're picking on wives, I think it's my wife.
Oh.
Man? Man?
No, the basic idea was to name some member of the female sex who is well endowed, you see. What did you say, Bowser?
This might be a low blow, don't she? I said, Ms. Lillian. You know, go with your first instinct, right?
Yeah, wrong in that case.
Wrong in this case.
Right.
Grandma Moses.
Grandma Moses. Did she,
Well, you don't know for sure, so
no.
It's as good as any answer.
That's right.
I don't get to play,
you could
huh?
have fooled me, Charles. You don't play.
Oh.
What do you have, Bill?
I was going to say Orson Welles, but I said Dolly Parton, so...
The definitive answer.
All right, make it four, Dolly Parton.
Make it four, right. Yeah, that's right. You got the idea now, Robin?
I'm catching it on, Sam.
All right, Jim, here's yours. Paul the plumber said, I'm in horrible pain. I haven't been the same since I sat on my blank. Paul the plumber. Paul the plumber said, I'm in horrible pain. I haven't been the same since I sat on my blank.
Toilet plunger.
The plunger.
Pardon right. me?
He said the plunger.
The plunger.
He sat on the plunger.
He hasn't been the same since he sat on the plunger!
That's
plunger.
That's two of those. Nice score.
One more.
Oh, what a surprise.
Okay, Jim, come on down. What's the rest of me here?
Born is fully.
All right. We're going to wheel you off, Robin. We'll be back for game number two, so just sit tight and we'll take a ride for you. Okay, goodbye, Robin, temporarily. Now. Here we go. Now, you can have a go at the really big money. You could win over $10,000 here. Let's have a go at it, Jim. We polled a studio audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Sue Blank. If you give us the answer they wrote down most often, you get $500. Right. Now, if you give us the second most popular answer, you get $250. Then, if you give us the third most popular answer, you get $100.
All righty.
Now, three of these six goons over here can give you some assistance there. Now, stand up there and take a look at them. Take a look at them. And only call the ones who are trying to get your attention.
I see.
The ones who have...
He's a tall person. He's taller than you are, sweetheart.
Call on the ones with an intelligent look on their face.
How about Fanny?
How about Fanny?
Bill, don't you want to give your answer, sweetie? wait a minute. What about Sue Me?
Yeah.
Sue Me.
Sue Me.
Shoot bullets through me. I love you.
Sue Pellegrini.
Sue Pellegrini.
Who is Sue Pellegrini, please?
Graduating class, Weaver High School, 1948, and nobody will forget her. Lookout Mountain, Sue Pellegrini was quite a thing. But anyway, I'll go with Sioux City, Iowa.
I got it for you,
I'd much
Jim.
Rather go with Sue Pellegrini.
You were with him, in fact.
One
I remember.
More.
He's already made his choice if Charles would shut up long enough for him to, me to get a word in here. That wonderful character that Betty White played on the Mary Tyler Moore Show, Sue Ann.
Well, not even
Alan
London. All right. I learned
that
her name.
Now you've got Sue Ann, Sioux City, Iowa, and Sue Me are the three they've given you. Do you want one of those, or do you want to give us one of your own?
Maybe Sue Ann.
I came up with Susie Q.
Susie Q. Well, that's
Susie Q.
Jim.
You want that?
Yeah. I like it.
Yeah.
I like it, Jim.
All right.
I like it.
Let's find out if it's up there. Let's take a look at the $100 number. Sue B. Sue B is a brand name of a kind of honey that you buy in the A&P.
I thought it was what you did when you wanted a pig to come around.
No.
Sue.
Let's take a look at the $250 response. Sue Ann Langdon. Sue Ann Langdon is up there.
Oh, okay.
All right, last chance.
How did they spell
for your answer?
A&E.
Let's see the $500 number. Sue me was Fanny's answer. Yeah. Well, listen, you didn't win any money, and but you're gonna have a chance at one more game here.
Never mind. Jim.
And right after this commercial, while we bring your opponent out, it'll play the other game. Okay. Final game, Robin. You want A or B?
A.
Robin says she wants A, and that's what she's going to get. Ralph said, there's an old saying, you are what you eat. I never believed it until I saw a politician eating a blank sandwich. Yeah. Ralph said, there's an old saying, you are what you eat. I never believed it until I saw a politician eating a blank sandwich. A politician eating a blank, you are what you eat.
A blank look.
Now think about it this time. You blew it last time.
I know.
You're not going to blow it this time.
Got it, right.
You got it.
Mm-hmm.
You're sure this is it?
Positive.
Better get up and
positive.
Jog a bit. Want to run around the stage a couple times?
Would it help your brain if you jogged a little, got a little oxygen in your
system? No, this time I'm ready to go.
All right.
Go, baby.
This is it. This is
a
just
Jimmy Carter sandwich.
You blew it again.
You.
That's two.
Robin Citron.
Here we go.
Am I first again?
John, you're up.
I realized halfway through it, I changed my answer. This, I think, is the right answer, actually. Bologna.
Bologna!
Also, I wanted to prove I could spell it. See, this is spelled correctly, too.
Bologna, yes. Pronounced Bologna.
Spell the rumors that I'm stupid.
Only yesterday I was watching television. I saw a politician. I said, you're full of baloney.
Full of baloney.
Yeah.
That's two. That's a definitive answer.
Two misspellings of baloney against one.
There are two ways to spell baloney.
Bologna, as in Italy. What do you say, Gina?
Bologna, well, I think that they...
Yes. Some of them are hams, right?
I know to spell baloney, so I just wrote real fast. Like
Balloon.
Bologna.
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 There it is. It was too easy. You tried to make it too hard.
No.
The rest of the contestants waiting backstage. This is an easy game. Don't try and make it hard, dingbat. Okay. Shall we go on?
All right.
Ruth said, I've got the world's strangest clock. Every night at 12 o'clock, the bird comes out and blanks.
PS-188?
Double, double.
You want to know how many years now?
How many years? Eight.
Mrs. Lazarus, and then it was Mrs. Lash.
Now put your card
Miss Oshman, but she got married, became Miss Free.
Put that in the slot, kid.
Ruth said, I've got the world's strangest clock. Every night at 12 o'clock, the bird comes out and blinks.
Tinkles?
Tinkles.
Tinkles.
Then Mrs. Friedman.
Yeah.
This is the answer I like best. The bird comes out and sings Ram-a-Lama Ding Dong.
That's very good.
That would be my kind of clock. It was right. Also better answer than this trash. I put belches.
Well, that's all right. Where comes any noise that the
Sir,
bird would make would
yeah,
be fine.
He comes out, he has a piece of dry toast, a hard-boiled egg, and belches.
Oh, that's it. Okay.
That's it.
Comes out and makes doo-doo on the minute hand.
Oh, no. I'm real
Charles,
embarrassed.
You're too much. Why are you embarrassed?
Well,
every night at 12 o'clock, the bird comes out and what?
And moos?
Moos.
My first instinct was what he said, but I was told I couldn't say it.
Oh, it's stranger, right?
Ooh.
Oh, God.
Still.
Mine comes out and does 5 minutes of jokes. Which,
is that what it says? Does 5 minutes of jokes.
That's cute.
It's right. Don't explain it. We'll never know whether you got it right or wrong.
Every minute 12, a bird comes out and does 5 minutes of jokes. That's good. What do you got there,
Fanny? Well, my bird is very confused. It comes out and asks, what time is it?
I'm going to meet your bird. All right. So the score is tied. As you can see, it's a real tough battle here.
Yeah, it's tough.
Zip to zip. And we go to round two. And since Robin went first last time, we'll ask you to go first this time.
A, please.
A it is. All right. Sam said, my father never liked me.
Aw.
Aw.
Every time there was a thunderstorm, he'd make me hold on to a blank. My father never liked me.
Every time there was a thunderstorm, he'd make me hold on to a blank. Spices it up a little.
Woo! Spices up life.
Yes. Yeah.
We're all set. Sam said my father never liked me. Every time there was a thunderstorm, he'd make me hold on to a blank.
Lightning rod?
Lightning rod is perfectly reasonable. What'd you say, John?
Come you on, know, Baker. I thought about that. But would anything happen to you if you held on to the actual rod? Oh,
yeah. Yes, dear.
It would, you're sure?
You'd be electrocuted.
You would be electrocuted.
Right.
Well, see, I thought tree. I
tree
went
would be the same
I went
thing.
The other way.
The tree
you know
sometimes
I mean?
Acts as a lightning
never
rod.
Never stand under a tree in a thunderstorm.
All right, come on. Lay it. Get it out of your systems. You can do it. That's enough.
Oh, is he loud?
Grow up.
Go.
You can get it out of your systems and be ready to cheer. Lightning rod.
There's one. Okay.
Tree.
So we have two trees and one lightning rod. See, a tree does act
do
as
I
a lightning rod in
now.
A thunderstorm, indeed. Gina, what did you say?
I got lightning rod.
There it is. Two for him.
I said hold on to Benjamin Franklin, who was holding on to a kite.
That would give you a little jolt, wouldn't it?
Wouldn't it?
Not a good joke, but a jolt.
Right. Fanny?
Lightning rod.
That's three for him. So you've got three, and we'll have yours in a moment or so. Right now, this for you. Thank you all. You were wonderful.
Oh,
Gene
Maybe
you'll join us next time at the Match Game. Goodbye.
Today's consolation prizes are... A tote bag, a lip quencher gloss stick, the moisturizing lip gloss by Chapstick. The more you use, the more you shine, because the unique gloss stick formula is easy to control. And from Hawaiian Tropic comes an attractive beach mat and Hawaiian Tropic natural tanning lotions and oils, Hawaiian Tropic, the tan of the islands. And Foster Grant designs sunglasses to make the world look a little different to you and vice versa. And from the Jovan perfume collection for women, musk oil, sex appeal, VSP Sports Center Woman by Jovan. And Bowl of Beauty Preserve Real Roses, always the perfect gift, nature's most beautiful flowers, available at your local florist or gift stores. And Deft Clear Wood Finish, a tough, durable wood finish that dries in 30 minutes, does not yellow or darken with age, from Deft Incorporated. And a baby bath and changing pad plus Diaperine baby washcloths, moisture-packed towelettes with lanolin that clean and condition. Keep your baby better than clean with Diaperine. Bill Todman Productions. This program was edited for broadcast.